You have an idea that you need to bring to life, and you don't know where to start. Well, I'm going to show you how I use FoamCore to bring ideas to life. My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. In my previous videos about FoamCore, we'll cover some of the basics, such as making a cube, how to do that the right way, making cylinders, soft corners, beveled edges, how to cover your foam and not leave any exposed, and using foam core in unconventional ways to create things like compound surfaces in ways you've never thought you could use foam core before. All of those techniques are used in this build. You might want to go back and check them out. The design for this speaker is based on a sketch that I did in 2015. I did a video on it. It's not the greatest sketch that I've ever done, and it was done on newsprint. It was done pretty quick, but I thought it would lend itself to a really nice model. It would allow me to spend some time exploring the proportions and working out some of the details of that concept. We're going to start building this mock-up by building a superstructure or a frame that everything is going to be built around. And I'm going to build this frame in such a way that it is adjustable, because I am not 100% sure yet about some of the proportions, and I want to mess around with that. And so building a frame that is adjustable allows me to do that. And you can see I built some simple discs and a rail system that everything can be adjusted to. So once I'm happy with the proportions, I slide it into the right place and I glue everything together with white glue to let it dry. And here's my finished frame that we're going to build everything on top of. To make the pattern for the foam core, I'm going to offset the surfaces, the thickness of the foam, and I'm going to use some white paper and wrap it around that to make a pattern. I'm going to pin them in place, and I'm going to use a pen and mark that and cut out that pattern, and that's going to be my pattern for the speakers on the end. Next, we're going to attach the screen. Here I've just used a piece of cardstock, like maybe a Bristol board, and spray painted it with a gray primer, and that's going to be the color to represent my screen in a very simple kind of way. I'm just pinning it in place here after I've added some white glue. So let's get back to building the speaker cones. I'm going to take that paper pattern from before and I'm going to trace it onto my foam core, and I'm going to cut that shape out. Next, I'm going to mark or grid the edges of the foam, because we're going to use some V-cuts here and put that into this curved piece of foam that we have, so that we can actually wrap it around the end of the frame that we've made. Here I'm just attaching a little bit of white glue all around, taping the ends so that when I get to the other end I can tape it together. I'll put some pins to start to hold the foam core in place, and I can easily wrap it around the frame. So a lot of planning went into all of this to make this come out. It may take you a couple of times if you've never done this before. There will be some trial and error. I put the tape on the end to seal it all up. Looks nice. I even get a little clamp because I want to get the piece of foam halfway onto that disc to be in the right spot. Now we're going to move on to the other end and basically repeat the process that we did before. For the main body, we're going to cover our foam core with a piece of packing tape before we start. This is going to give us a glossy surface to simulate a material change. Next, we're going to grid up the foam core. I cover this technique extensively in the previous foam core video for making compound surfaces. It's an offset grid on both sides of the foam core and allows the foam core to flex in a get you compound surfaces. The ends of the foam core need to be curved, because it wraps around a cylinder and it has a concave surface. So we're going to start at the very bottom, and we're just going to pin that in place and glue it and let that dry before we start to roll it around the form. The next piece up is where the screen goes, and I'm cutting out the screen here very carefully with an X-Acto knife. So we're gonna butt up this piece that I just cut out for the screen to the previous piece that's on the mock-up already. And again, we're gonna glue that edge up first and we're gonna let that dry. We're gonna hold that in place with a little bit of tape while that dries up. And that's gonna give us the best continuous surface from one piece of foam core to the next. We're going to wrap that afterwards, after it's dried, and we're going to use some rubber bands to sort of hold things in place. We're going to repeat this process throughout the entire body. I will say that this is a pretty unusual build in the sense that you have these compound surfaces that wrap, but it's an excellent use of this gridded technique, and it works out quite well. You'd have a tough time doing this out of any other sort of sheet material unless you turn something on a lathe. We continue to repeat this process every time, the same thing. We butt up the end piece first, let that dry, tape it into place so we get a nice transition from one piece to the next, and then we roll that across the form once it's dried. Each time, I'm always using Elmer's glue or a white glue. I just find it so much better than hot glue that pulls strings and make a mess. Yes, it takes longer to dry, but your finish in the end is so much nicer, and the quality is totally worth it. We only have a few things left to do. One of them is to make the bezel between the screen and the outer body. Again, we're going to cover a piece of Bristol board here with some clear packing tape to get it shiny so it matches the texture of the exterior body. Again, gluing stuff in with some PVA, super nice and clean, allows me to make adjustments and get the piece just right. I tape everything in with a white artist tape to hold it in place while it dries. Once it's dry, I'm just going to come back in with an X-Acto and I'm going to edge trim it, just like we've done the same in some of the past videos where we've used tape to hide the foam. We have one last thing to do, and that's to tape up the exposed foam on the edge where we put the speakers on in the very beginning. Put down some white artist tape and then come back with my knife and trim it up. A mock-up like this allows you to explore proportions and check out scale. Here it is against my Wahey-C1 Bluetooth speaker, so you can check it out for size. If you're in the market for like a budget Bluetooth speaker, this Wahey-C1 is pretty nice. It's pretty thin, it's circular, it's not the super highest build quality, the sound is pretty decent. I like it, it's portable, I use it around my studio. You can check out the link below for that on Amazon. Anyway, here it is, nice studio shot, all finished, mock-up, came out nice, I like the proportions, it was a worthwhile exercise and definitely something that you want to do when you're doing your product development. It's just a great way to move your product from one phase to the next as you're doing your design work. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.